It's somebody that when I think about the show, I talk in the third person always. Fred and I say, Liza wouldn't do that. Liza wouldn't... Fine. Liza has to change. Liza would now say, you know, because I want to keep myself to myself so much. So it's easier for me to talk about what I'm presenting on stage in the third person. And as this great big, you know, L-I, big Z-A.
Did y'all see the way that... See, I'm already down here before...
Now we're going crazy. But we've been working actually in rehearsal for 4 full weeks. And before that, the planning we planned for about 2 months.
Did y'all know...
Everything has to be just right. And the hard part is making it look easy. You know, making it flow. Making it be what I'd like to watch.
Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me and walk right by me and never know I'm there. I tell you, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me and walk right by me and never know I'm there.
Suppose you was a little cat residing in a person's flat who fed you fish and scratched your ears.
You'd notice him.
Suppose you was a woman wed, a sleeping in a double bed beside one man for 7 years.
Should've been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me and walk right by me and never know I'm there. I tell ya, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should've been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can... See, I was standing.
You have the power to hypnotize me. Let me live under your spell. Come on, do that voodoo.
Voodoo? Wait a minute. What are you trying to say? Voodoo?
Oh.
Talk to me. I hear you, baby.
Something to be.
I do.
That nobody else.
Nobody else? Thanks a lot. I hope I didn't take up too much of your time.
I want to be entertained. You know, that's how I usually start thinking conceptually about a show. What would I like to see? What would make me happy if I saw it? You know, make me laugh.
All right, Liza, I'm sorry.
Oh, that's all right, Freddie.
Without a statement. Let's go back into the introduction.
Okay, look. For me.
One, two.
Very good to travel if you have to work hard with people that are supportive and professional and who care for you as much as you care for them.
Jay, I'll walk into it and you can pick me up. Look. For me.
One, two.
Talking about like Helen, who you met, and Carol, and the musicians.
Jay! Pat! Steve! Arnie! Everywhere I go, I look around and see 12 fellas following me. Would you say I'm lucky? Well, I must agree. 12 fellas. My band.
Well, I've worked with most of them at one point or another, but this is the first time they've all come together in one group. And it's really marvelous. Because, as you heard today now, the sound in this theater is bizarre. But they sound like 30 pieces, and there's only 12.
Everybody gets the blues. Everybody gets the blues. Everybody gets the blues. Now you got it. Everybody knows the way that you feel today.
You got this optimistic character from your parents?
My parents.
Your parents,
oh,
both
definitely.
Of them.
Yes.
I mean, they both had that.
I think I got my patience from my father.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's terribly patient. And my humor. And from my mother, I got my humor and that funny point of view. They both were terribly, terribly funny people.
Talk about your parents respectively and say whether you've seen their films or not, or?
Oh, sure. The kids sort of used to talk, but not really, because we didn't have much sense of that. You know who used to talk a lot? The nannies.
Oh, really?
They used to get together and discuss the lighting on their employer's last film. At all the birthday parties, they were saying, well, I didn't think the leading man was that great in the last picture, you know. And they were hilarious. You know, and it was a group of nannies who just made the rounds in Hollywood. There was Mademoiselle and Fraulein and Nanny and
which one did somebody you have?
I had all of them. We all had all of them. They just kept going around.
City lights.
and I'd wanted to be an ice skater. Then I saw Bye Bye Birdie. I saw all these kids dancing and the lights and the scenery and the fun they seemed to be having. And what I think I really liked was they looked like a unit. The dressing room downstairs, they looked like they all had fun, looked like a big family. So lay back, mama, my crack, and the thresher's up, my pressure's up, silly. Oh, I'm a silly
one work on one's voice?
Well, through breathing, mm-hmm. and through listening to yourself, to make sure you're not flat or sharp, to get the right tone, to control the breath so you get the quality of the note, so that it sounds like you're talking, but you're actually talking on music.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I wanna be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep, to find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. My little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'd make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New
that some songs has a meaning with your life.
Oh, you yes, know, absolutely.
And then, you know, 2 years later, because you're in a different mood or you're
sure.
a different person.
Sure, sure. And then there are constants that always get you crazy. You know, like there's some old songs that every time I hear them, I just go, oh, I'm God. I love that so much. Oh, like, you know, what is it? It's a beautiful, I could be a king, dear, uncrowned, humble or poor, rich or renowned. I love that song. It's an old song. Some of Gershwin, Rodgers and Hart.
Someday he'll come along, the man I love, and he'll be big and strong, the man I love. And when he comes,
Terribly sorry about that. Are you the justice of the peace?
That's right.
You are. I'm sorry about the window. It's just, you know, we're a little anxious. Is there a possibility that we could be married now? We're in a bit of a hurry. I can't even explain to you why. I wish I could. You can see the way we look. Please close this up, honey.
Now?
Yeah. Could you please just take about 2 minutes of your time? We'll make it worth your while. And I will pay for the glass, too. Could you please?
Well, I guess it
could. Oh, yeah. We can arrange it. Yes,
we can arrange it.
Come on.
Come on.
Just a minute.
Aren't you sure?
Yeah, just 1 second.
You're kidding, right?
Kidding what?
That was it.
What was what?
Your proposal. There, get your coat on, put on your shoes.
You're not sure, believe me.
No, I just thought...
What?
Nothing. I just thought it would be different. You know what I mean?
Different. It is different.
I know it's different.
Well, then what's the
problem? It's not the kind of different I
had
in mind.
What's the problem?
The kind of different I had in mind was maybe sweet and calm and...
It is calm!
And art.
I'm sorry.
That's good.
It's just a little... It's...
And pretty, you know.
What?
Pretty.
It's pretty!
You can't say that.
It is pretty.
You can't
what
look.
Is, what?
You can't say it's pretty.
I want to marry you! What are you talking about? Please, go inside. Go inside. This is private. Would you wait 1 second? I'm coming. Did you hear what I said?
Yes.
I want to marry you. Okay. Okay? What's the matter? What do you want me to do?
Do
you want me to kill myself over this, darling? Listen, when I say now, you back up. That's it.
Jimmy, wait a minute. Don't back up. Don't move.
No!
No! No! The movies are too special to me. Through my father, you know. And, of course, my mother. But in film, through my father.
Yeah.
They're too special to me to, take it as much, liberty with it as I would live on stage. Because I can see an audience. I can tell what they're thinking. You can feel it. Your skin can feel it. Every hair on your body can feel it. It goes right up the back of your spine. You can just feel it. In a film, you're totally in a director's hands.
Bye. Bye. Wonder why mine hair, I've always said that I was a rover. You mustn't knit your brow, you should have known by now. You'd every cause to doubt me, mine hair. Bye-bye, mine hair.
I guess maybe I'd rather put myself on the line without trusting, just saying, exposing myself without trust, necessarily, but willing to get knocked down, knowing that maybe that person will pick me up, as opposed to really trusting and believing in something. I think that that's part of growing up, too. You lose a few of your illusions.
Have you
everything
been knocked out? in your life?
Oh, many times. Many times, but I wouldn't have missed one of them.
Do you think that each time it's easier to survive than knocked out? Or?
I find that it's very easy to say that in an interview like this. That it's very easy to be, cool. about it. Kind of like Warren Beatty, you know? When you go through it, no. Because you feel like a fool. You've done it again.
But you
and you just might go crash and hit yourself and say, oh, how could I have been such an idiot? But then that funny ability that I was talking about to pull back and to talk to yourself and say, sweetheart, you were an idiot. Now forget about it and get up and go out and have a chocolate sundae. And you'll feel better, you know. Go for a ride in the park. Go for a walk. Go buy a hat. Nobody's bought a hat in years. For when the sake of buying a hat with a veil.
Tell
you know
me
what
the
I mean?
Truth. When is the last time you bought a hat?
With a veil?
Yes.
I bought one with a black, you know, the black velvet polka mm-hmm. dots. You look like a Linda Darnell. And about 2 weeks ago.
Uh-huh. Why?
I got lonely. Something that you can do. My godmother wrote a song called Bazazz, you know, and the words are wonderful to it. And I never learned how to play the piano, but I learned how to play every once in a while parts of songs.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And the words to this particular song say, if you've got that certain something, that's pizzazz. That extra special kind of something. That's pizzazz. If you've got enough of that wonderful stuff, let it sparkle and fizzle fast. Let it glimmer and glow so everybody will know that, honey, you got pizzazz. If you got a smile that kills them, that's pizzazz. That extra special thing that thrills him. Bazazz, honey, is what you have. Now, this is the important part. You don't need beauty. You don't need brains and all the rest of that jazz. Hang on to what you got, because what you got is bazazz.